national letter has a gloomy prediction for the Republican presidential nominee's immigration plan. It's the University of Pennsylvania's Wharton School, and it estimates that the plan to deport 11 million undocumented workers would actually kill 4 million jobs by 2030. In comparison, it says Hillary Clinton's proposal to create a pathway to citizenship would cost around 400,000 jobs over the same period. The whole question of Donald Trump's economic plan is now very much under debate and discussion. In just a moment, we're going to be talking to one of Mr. Trump's economic supporters and on his economic council and advisers, who will be telling us why the critics perhaps are wrong. But first, though, Christina Alessi is with me to dissect and to set the, if you like, the parameters for our discussion. Christina, what do the critics say about Mr. Trump's plan?
Well, let's put the immigration stuff on the side for a second.
Economics.
So let's stick to taxes, trade, regulation, three big tenets of his policy. On taxes, Mr. Trump came out and said he's going to reduce the taxes for everyone, essentially three tax brackets, right? 12, 25, and 33%. Now, if you remember when he came out with his original plan, that top bracket was at 25%. And most economists and experts said it would cost, you know, an extra $10 trillion, add an extra $10 trillion to our national debt. So he's revised that. Most experts say it'll cost less, but it's still going to cost us a lot of money. Right. On trade, he's saying that he's going to implement strong protections against currency manipulation, and he's going to put tariffs on cheaters, right? How we're going to do that, still a little bit fuzzy on all the details, but most pro-trade people will say this does not account for the fact that we are losing manufacturing jobs because of innovation and technology improvements, which his plan does not really address. Third, regulation. Every business on the face of this in the U.S. is really happy to hear about less and less regulation. Big, medium, and small businesses want more of this. The problem is that Trump is saying that regulation under Obama has cost America jobs. That's not necessarily true. When you look at the energy sector, a lot of these jobs have been lost because of the price of oil. Now, The Economist.
Yes, The Economist.
The Economist came out with a very strong anti-Trump message, right? And they are a free trade publication, basically saying his proposal threatened the jobs and living standards of millions of Americans. Rarely has a candidate for president been less deserving of such a leap of faith.
That's the background. Thank you, Christina. We've been watching these things. Now let's talk about this with a bit more. Thank you very much, Christina. Betsy McCoy is a Trump supporter who's listed as a member of Mr. Trump's economic policies. We're talking taxes.
Thank you.
You heard there, Christina Alessi, putting into perspective the tax plan.
She left out the most important part of the tax plan, which is the reduction in corporate tax rates. That's what's killing the economy. American companies pay the highest corporate tax rates in the world, not just nominally at 35%, but across the board, the average is about 27%, much higher than other countries in the world.
The Committee for Responsible Tax, whatever the foundation is, says that that tax cut on the corporate tax will raise the deficit by $2.3 trillion.
It will not. Let me explain why. And in fact, the Tax Foundation has demonstrated why it will actually increase revenue over the course of a decade. We collect about $273 billion a year in corporate income taxes, but when you lower corporate tax rates, you increase business activity. Companies invest more in the tools that labor uses. Wages go up. Income goes up. Corporate income goes up. And as a result, tax revenues go up. You see an increase in the payroll tax. You see an increase in individual income tax revenues. And over the course of a decade, you will see a $400 million per year increase in total tax revenue.
But in Donald Trump's plan, not only is he cutting the corporate level, he's cutting the income tax level as
well. That's right, but I do want to make one more point about this.
Before we get to your other point, if we may, and at the same time, he's increasing expenditures on things like defense whilst protecting social care.
It reminds us very much of what Ballooned the deficit.
He ballooned the deficit.
That's right, he did. But over the course of a decade, he produced enormous prosperity. Here's where I'm coming from on this. Voters this time around have a choice between class warfare and economic growth. I'm choosing growth, and here's why. 8 million more people are living in poverty today than when Barack Obama took office. 14.5% of our people are living in poverty. And why? Stagnant wages and few job opportunities.
But the entire Trump plan rests on greater economic growth.
That's right.
And nobody has ever seen the level of growth necessary to make up the shortfall from tax revenues by lowering taxes. So, a question. Do you accept that in the short term, this balloons the deficit?
Oh, there's no question that it does. But Americans will be better off. They are enduring very stagnant wages. And when you
cut... Well, that's not true. The wage growth has risen. If you look at the last numbers, wage growth is up between 3 to 5%.
It's not satisfactory, and you know it. And more or less, more than that, our economy is now limping along at 1.2% growth, despite robust consumer demand. Why?
No, you can't
because
have
businesses
this.
No. are not investing.
No, 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 with respect. I accept that 1.2 to 1.5% growth is subpar, but...
Subpar?
But
we can't survive with that. Under Reagan's recovery, it was 4.5%.
They were different eras with different economics, and if you take
we
the U.S.
We can get back to that.
We
can get back to that
level.
Well,
not when you've got the EU growing at less than 1%.
Ireland grew 7.8% last year.
That is completely fallacious, and you know it, because... Because Ireland was coming out of a dramatic recession, and it was a bounce back as a result of the
bailout.
Look
at their corporate tax rate, 12.5%.
Yes, and look at what's happened with Ireland and its corporate tax rate at 12.5%. And look at what the UK is proposing to do because of Brexit.
Slash rates. They're all slashing rates to be competitive, except the United States, where Hillary Clinton is running ads that say corporations ought to pay their fair share. That's the most demagogic ad I've ever seen. Americans ought to know corporations are paying the highest rates in the world here.
So, do you also support, along with this, measures to, for example, allow the repatriation
of overseas money? That's a very good idea, because that temporary repatriation, I'm glad you brought that up, will bring in $2.1 trillion, which will enable companies to invest that here in the tools for productivity.
So why go for, other than, frankly, political philosophy.
I like your spirit, by the way.
Well, I could admire yours as well. The estate tax. Now, all right, inheritance tax, death duties, whatever you want to call it.
Right.
You must accept that it will only benefit the truly rich.
Well, it will benefit people who start small businesses and want to pass them on to their children, and farmers. This is a major issue in the agricultural parts of the nation.
You can change the rules to allow for farmers without giving Donald Trump and his family a $4 billion advantage.
You're falling for that class warfare rhetoric. You know it's kind of silly.
No, I'm not. It's a fact. I mean, God forbid, Mr. Trump. I mean,
if somebody works their whole life to build a drugstore chain or a farm, why should they have to sell it because the estate tax at 50% was taking half of it?
But why give the truly rich a tax break at the same time?
They've already paid taxes on their income.
Well, what I hope is that you will come back to discuss other aspects.
It's a deal.
Because there's a lot more that we need to get to grips
Absolutely.
With.
We talked to next time regulation.
Plenty of talk about regulation. We'll regulate the regulation. Thank you. Stay well. Thank you. Now, on Wall Street, I'm exhausted. On Wall Street, stocks fell from Monday's records.